Howdy, Ramblers.
I'm Amber.
And I'm Eric.
And we're Ramblin' Bears. And this is Bear Bulletin number 2.
Yep, that's a show where we dig through the trash bins of the internet and bring you all the tastiest outdoor and nature news.
Mm-hmm. And today we have a lot of great news for you guys today. There's actually a lot of ocean news, which is fitting because we have a big Pacific storm coming our way. So, yeah.
Well, to get started, have you noticed that shrimp's no longer a luxury item? There's a lot of cheap shrimp on the market. 20 years ago, the U.S. got 80% of its shrimp from domestic wild fisheries. Today, 90% of that shrimp comes from imports, and a lot of that is from shrimp farms. About half of those farms are in cut-down mangrove forests. And if you've never seen mangroves, they're really cool forests of plants that are in swampy areas at the edge of the ocean. Cutting down those mangroves reduces the amount of carbon that the plants are storing. Those mangrove forests support the wild fisheries there, so in many cases the shrimp farming has actually displaced fisheries that were there before, and some researchers think that it may be as much as 10 times as much of a carbon footprint as beef production for some of these shrimp farms due to all of the mangrove cutting, which is a lot like slash and burn. And the worst part is that many of these cease to be productive after about 5 years because the soil gets acidified and muddy.
You think shrimp is a luxury? Try lobster. In Maine, they just found one of the biggest lobsters they've ever found there. It was the size of a three-year-old child, practically. And normally, fishermen have restrictions on people keeping lobsters that are over 5 inches, but this one they kept for a little while just to measure. They found that it was, if you can believe it, 27 pounds. It was huge, and its claws were big enough to break your arm if they got a grab, you know, hold of you. But it isn't actually the largest lobster that's ever been found in the world. That goes to a lobster in Nova Scotia that was found that was 44 pounds, if you can believe it.
Well, by now you've probably heard about the controversial Keystone XL pipeline. It's supposed to bring oil from the Canadian tar sands down to the Gulf of Mexico. It's a politically charged issue, but more recently it has been uniting some people who may not have come together under any other circumstances. And that's because in some places landowners have actually accused TransCanada, the company that wants to build the pipeline, of sending them not quite threatening, but sort of bullying letters suggesting that they will use eminent domain powers to buy their land if they don't make a deal with TransCanada now in order to get land to put the pipeline through. And this has really angered people. Eminent domain is a really touchy issue and has brought in people that are traditionally more Republican or Libertarian, along with environmentalists who oppose the pipeline for other reasons. So really a case of strange bedfellows. And the real linchpin of this is that there's no, as of right now, any approval or permits for the pipeline. So they actually don't have any eminent domain power to actually make these claims.
Well, if you guys are a fan of Pompeii, you will definitely love this next story. There was a forest, petrified forest. It was actually a forest that was found under a natural disaster that happened that was a huge volcanic explosion, which put almost, I think it was 10,000 acres or something, in 39 inches of ash, which over, I think it was 300 million years, just made it exactly the same as it was, only hard and rock-like. So they could actually now look at plants that don't even exist anymore and get the details and learn all about this prehistoric, you know, world that came before us, which is really cool. And they found that in the highest canopy, the trees are up to 82 feet tall. And that must be amazing.
Well, another ocean story, back to the ocean. A UC Santa Cruz study on Kenyan tropical reefs has really highlighted the importance of looking at ecosystems from the very top to the very bottom. And this report exposed the effects of overfishing actually affecting the coral. They had an overabundance of sea urchins because there weren't as many fish to prey on the urchins, and then the urchins in turn were overeating this specific algae called coralline algae that actually deposits a little bit of calcium carbonate. And the coralline algae plays a critical role in reef health in actually attracting the coral to come and settle either on new areas or damaged areas. And it just really highlights the need to look at fishery management or wildlife management really from the top to the bottom, because a species anywhere along the food chain can have a profound effect.
Speaking of ocean news, we have one more little tidbit that I wanted to throw in because it's super exciting. So we all know James Cameron loves his movies about oceans. We got Titanic, we got The Abyss, you know, he's done tons of documentaries. Well, now he's working on something really exciting. He is trying to explore, he's on a team of scientists, there's four teams that are actually racing to get to the deepest part of the ocean that's ever been explored, and they're calling it the Race to Inner Space. So he's going to be taking off pretty soon into what's called the Mariana Trench, which is 36,000 feet deep, which is actually deeper than Everest's high, if you can even imagine. So there is a deep ocean record already set. They're trying to beat it and get down there. So we'll keep an eye on him and kind of see how it goes. It's pretty exciting.
Well, that about wraps up this Bear Bulletin. Links to all the stories down in the description. If there's any updates, we'll post those there too.
Yep. And if you have any questions or comments, go ahead and hit us up. We're on Facebook and Twitter and on YouTube, Ramblin' Bears. You'll find us.
Yep. And if you haven't seen some of our more recent videos, we've got Bodie, a song about the ghost town Bodie that we wrote, and also LA Mountain Adventure that we just had. And we started a covers channel in order to enter this Grateful Dead contest. So go there and watch our Ramble on Rose and like that so that maybe they'll pay attention to us.
And we have a lot of great new videos coming out too. We have a quest that we filmed during Beer Week, and we also have another new song that we're working on. So subscribe to our channel if you want to stay up to date on all the new stuff that we have coming.
Well, that should be it. All right, until next time, Ramble on.